Welcome to Woggle Guides. In this guide, I'll explain which Google Doc add-ons I use to help me write scripts faster and with better quality for my YouTube channel. And don't forget, you can click on any section below to go straight to the area of this guide that interests you the most. Please do subscribe if you like what you see, so we can let you know when new guides are published. Let's get straight into it. So like most YouTube creators, for every video I publish, I write a script as part of my workflow. This describes everything I want to say and do in the video. Now, this can be quite a time-consuming process, so I like to do anything I can to speed up that process and make it a little easier on me. I write all of my scripts using the free Google Docs app. It offers a lot of useful features which do help with script writing. However, in this guide, I'm going to share with you the free add-ons for Google Docs which really help me to speed up my script writing process. Let's get straight into it. In this first section of the guide, I'll explain what a Google Docs add-on is. If you want to get straight into the add-on reviews, however, then just click on the chapter links at the bottom of this video. Add-ons are tools that you can add to Google products like Google Docs. These then allow you to do more in Google Docs by adding new features or increasing what is possible with existing functionality. A small number of add-ons are developed by Google, but the majority are created by third-party developers approved by Google. Many add-ons are also free, but a number may ask for a one-time payment or a subscription payment to unlock additional features. Here at Woggle Guides, we focus on the free add-ons for Google products because we're big fans of free. If we recommend any paid apps, we'll make it clear that they're paid for and what they cost. Once installed, Google add-ons will work seamlessly with Google Docs via the right-hand navigation panel. If you want to find out how to install an add-on to Google Docs, then check out this Woggle guide in the link above, which explains how to do this. A link to this guide can also be found in the description for this video. So let's take a look at our first add-on for YouTube creators, Doc Builder. This add-on bolts onto Google Docs and allows you to quickly build a framework for a script using snippets. The real power of this feature is that it saves you having to retype or cut and paste some parts of a script which you might need to reuse regularly, such as introductions or sign-off sections for the script. With all of the add-ons I'll review in this video, I won't explain how to install them. If you need some help with this, take a look at the Woggle guide shown above. I'm already in Google Docs. To use any add-on, we need to open a new or existing document. I'm going to create a new one, and I can quickly do that by clicking on blank. And a new untitled document is now ready. Let's open the Doc Builder add-on by clicking on the add-ons link in the top menu bar. And if we move our mouse over the Doc Builder link, we can see there's an option to open sidebar. Let's choose that now. Like all add-ons, Doc Builder opens in the right-hand panel. By default, the add-on shows some example snippets and a README file that explains how it works. Let's find my Google Docs snippets to show you the power of this add-on. To help quickly find all my script elements, I have started each snippet title with the letters YT. Let's type that in the search box and press return. You'll see that a number of script elements are now shown. I'll now go through how I use this to build a script. I think of any script development as a series of building blocks. You start with an intro that explains the aims of the video. You add the sections of the video, and then you pull together the elements you want to add to the YouTube description. So this would look something like, I'll start with a title and file name for the video. Next, I'll add the introduction for the description, which is really the important first 100 or so words, which contain some of the keywords. I also like to add a transcript for my videos, which is pretty straightforward to do if you're writing a script. So let's add a section for that. Next, I want to build up the body of the description so that I can add in any links. And the first thing I like to add is a placeholder for the video chapters, also known as the key moments by YouTube. This just allows me to quickly signpost each of the sections in the video. Building on that, I also want to add some sections to the script to detail any useful links I reference in the video, and I also want to add a prompt for viewers to subscribe to the channel, as well as all the social info for the page. One last thing I find very useful is whenever I use any free images or sounds I've found in my videos, it's super quick to use Doc Builder to add any attribution for the websites to my description. And it saves me having to search out the URL each time and remember all the right words to use for each site. The music I use in most of my videos, and you're listening to it right now, is from bensound.com. So let's quickly add the link to that website to make sure we don't have any copyright issues. And that's all there is to putting together a quick script framework using Doc Builder. So now let's move on to my second Google Docs add-on for YouTubers, which helps you to move around a large script really quickly. A common problem when you're working with any large script is that it can be a bit of a hassle to navigate around it. So if we take a look at one of my recent video scripts, where I talked about how to add email accounts to Gmail, you'll see this is a pretty lengthy script. In fact, it's 16 pages long, so it does go on for a bit. Or at least I went on for a bit. When I'm writing my scripts, I often find that when I'm developing the content for each section, I might get some inspiration for a good keyword I want to use, or perhaps a link I want to add to the video description. On long scripts like this, it's really a chore to have to find and scroll to each section if I want to add some content. So if I want to add a keyword, I have to go all the way to the start of the document. Or if I want to update my video chapter timings, I've got to scroll to the bottom of the document and find the right section to update. Over the course of developing a long script, all of these delays can really add up and increase the time it takes to finish your script. Let's now open the Search and Navigate add-on to see how it can help us speed up this process. To open the add-on, we click in Add-Ons on the top navigation bar. And if we move our mouse over the Search and Navigate link, we can see there's a Start option. Let's choose that now. The Search and Navigate add-on then opens in the right-hand panel. As soon as it opens, it analyzes your document for headings and then displays a quick table of contents view. Now, if you haven't guessed yet, the great thing about this add-on is that you only need to click on a heading link. As you can see, this massively speeds up not only how you navigate around the script, but also how quickly you can update it. One important tip to remember when using this add-on is that it makes use of Google Docs' own heading formats to recognize which links to display in the table of contents. So if we click on the description link, you'll see the two other links are nested underneath that link. This is achieved by using different heading labels for each. So if I highlight the description heading, this is a heading 2. However, both the YouTube title and video description are heading 3. If I want to add a further nested link below the YouTube title link, all I need to do is highlight the text I want to link to. Let's choose video file name. I then change the heading format to heading 4, using the drop-down in the taskbar. And if I tap the refresh icon on the Search and Navigate add-on, you can see that the link for the video file name label now appears in the table of contents. The final add-on I want to share with you to help you with your script development is the consistency checker. As the name suggests, this add-on checks that you're using keywords and phrases in your script in a consistent way. This can be important for SEO and to ensure your YouTube descriptions are well laid out. I like to think of this feature as an improvement on the spell checking function that is already offered by Google Docs. Let's take a look at how it works. To open the add-on, we click on Add-ons again in the top navigation menu. And if we move our mouse over the consistency checker option, we can see there's an option to open. Let's choose that now. The consistency checker add-on then opens in the right-hand panel. Now you'll see that this add-on is currently in beta testing, which is why it's free. But that may change in the future. Using the consistency checker is very straightforward. The first thing we want to do is scan the YouTube script we're currently working on. To do that, tap the large blue scan button. The add-on then reviews your document and produces a report. This normally takes a few seconds. Let's now step through the report to see what kinds of information it gives us. The first area it talks about is words with and without hyphens in them. Now, it's quite possible that you may want to refer to the same phrase in different ways throughout a script for SEO purposes. But like in this case with the phrase wrap-up, it can be a genuine error. Solving and checking the problem is really quick. To do that, I click in Edit in the top menu bar, and then Find and Replace. In the box that pops up, I'll enter the word wrap-up, and click Next to find it in the document. Once I've found it, I can close the box by clicking the X in the corner. And if I tap into the document, I can then amend the word correctly. Once I've done that, I'll click Rescan in the consistency checker, and you'll see the issue's been removed. So that gives you an idea of the information this add-on can give you. Let's quickly step through the other report pages by clicking Next at the bottom of the add-on. The next section looks at words which have been hyphenated. If you need, you can change and update your script in exactly the same way as I've showed you for the first report page. Next, we have variations in spelling. I find this particularly useful for US and UK word differences. And again, you may want to put those variations into your script for SEO purposes. Moving on, this page looks at how numbers have been used in the sentence, whether the full word has been written or actual digits have been used. The next report error is a big problem of mine, contractions. That is whether in your script you've shortened cannot to can't, or do not to don't. As you can see, I do it a lot. I don't honestly think this affects SEO. I'm not an expert though, so if it worries you, then you know how to make the changes. Next up, we have compound words, which again highlights any differences in how words are used in the script. And the last report page looks at how abbreviations have been used in the document. Any differences in usage are highlighted and can be amended by you. And remember, if you want to navigate to any individual report pages again, you can do that by clicking on the back or next buttons. I hope you found this Woggle guide useful. If you have, please like or subscribe so that other users can find it too. Thanks for watching, and do look after yourself until next time.